Hey guys, what's up? It's Murda here with another episode of Analyze This. I'm on the test server. I'm not in VR though because it is, I believe, disabled from the last test. So I'm sitting here in the warp gate, but nonetheless, we can still make this work. Anyway, this time we're doing a follow-up to my very first episode of the series on scope selection and sensitivity. Today we're going to be exclusively talking about a new, much-desired feature that currently shows up on the test server. And it'll likely go live with Game Update 9 very soon. And of course, I'm talking about the ADS sensitivity slider. Now that's something that myself and many other competitive first-person shooter gamers have been asking for a very long time, and I'll go on to explain why. But first let me say that I really wanted to get this video out quickly because many of you will find yourselves frustrated logging in on patch day, which might be very soon, tomorrow, the day after. I'm not sure if they're still able to push it out this week. But anyway, you might find yourself frustrated logging in on the patch day if you aren't properly prepared. And now that's because the new ADS sensitivity slider defaults to the value of 0.5, like all of the sliders do. But this is a brand new independent slider that's being introduced to the game for the first time. So unless you never touched any of your in-game sensitivities before, you'll probably notice that your ADS sensitivity with iron sights or 1x or 2x scopes is likely very different from the setting that you're used to. Now, for people who are in that boat, and you may not care how that you can now adjust your ADS sensitivity, but you rather just want to be able to get back to the settings that you're used to that you had before the patch, you'll want to make note of your current mouse sensitivity, this value in your settings, and be sure to set the ADS mouse sensitivity slider to the same value after the patch. I still believe, however, that even if you are in this boat, that the information in this video will still prove useful to you. So. Now anyway, the reason why this is such a great change is not only the fact that we have more control over our sensitivities, which is always a good thing for the serious gamer, but because in the past PlanetSide did not have a typical hipfire to ADS sensitivity ratio. Now in a game like Battlefield 3, for example, and many others, you can expect your ADS sensitivity to be 50% of your hipfire sensitivity. That is, you'll have to cover twice the distance on your mouse pad to complete the same degree turn when ADS and compared to hip firing. Now it's what many people have gotten very used to and what they expect, or at least expect to be able to set up in all of the games that they play in order to promote that muscle memory that we spoke so highly of in episode 1. Now in PlanetSide 2, however, your ADS is not 50% of your hip fire. It's not too far off, it is reasonably close, but that's simply not good enough when min-maxing your settings for the absolute best performance. Now in fact, I know a handful of either pro or competitive gamers for games like Battlefield 3 that stopped playing PlanetSide 2 for this very reason. It was screwing up their muscle memory and their ability to accurately hit targets when switching between both games. So now before I go further, let me clarify that the ADS sensitivity slider only adjusts sensitivity for iron sights and your 1X, which is your infrared, your night vision scope, or your normal reflex scopes, and your 2X scopes. Any scopes that are 3.4 times magnification and above still change as they always have with the scoped mouse sensitivity slider instead. Now that's been in the game since release, I believe, if not in beta. So nothing changes on that front, but this is for the 1X, 2X, and the iron sights, which previously all changed with this mouse sensitivity slider, which also did hipfire, which is where things got a little bit more complicated. So now, as I did in episode 1, I'm going to assume that you have a sensitivity that you're happy with, or at least a sensitivity in another first-person shooter game that you're comfortable with. Now, if not, I suggest spending some quality time in VR, taking Twitch shots at various target dummies. I can't right now because VR is closed on the test server. But doing things like that, covering different lengths, going from one, you know, to the other, left to right, first to third, first to fourth, whatever, changing it up kind of on the fly at random to better familiarize yourself and your wrist with the twitch aim that you need to hit different targets coming in at different angles and things like that. And when you have a sensitivity that you like, you'll either be able to match up your PlanetSide 2 settings with something that feels identical to your other game of choice, or if you've already done that, like I have, with your hipfire in the past, you can do like what I'm going to do and take my existing hipfire sensitivity that I have in PlanetSide already, which I have matched up to my hipfire from Battlefield 3 and so on and so forth, and then match up your ADS sensitivity to be that 50%. Now that you have the capability of fine-tuning that within your PlanetSide 2 settings. Now, in order to do this, I'm going to use the same technique that I've shown before, namely in episode 1 of this series. Now, that is setting up two solid objects on your keyboard, or rather on your mouse pad. One can be your keyboard if you desire, depending on your setup on your desk. Another one could just be anything that's solid enough that you hitting it lightly with your mouse is not going to move it. Now preferably you have a ruler in addition to this for precise measurements, and then you find a spot on your screen. Typically I'd use, you know, things in VR like the target dummies. A lot of things on your HUD are good if you happen to be near like an objective that says A, B, or C or something like that. And you use that as your starting point. I can use this. I'm aiming up a little bit, so that's not 100% ideal, but it gets the job done, focusing on this gun at the top of that terminal. And use that as your starting point, and you precisely move your mouse between the points on your mouse pad while keeping track of the distance traveled until you reach the desirable spot on your screen, which is typically, for me, a 360-degree turn, ending up back at the starting point so that I know how far I have to move in order to do a 360-degree turn. Now I'm going to do that first for hip fire, which I've done many times in the past when doing this for myself, and make sure you do it multiple times to make sure that your results are consistent, and then do it again for your ADS. Note that you can simply use this technique to fine-tune your PlanetSide 2 sensitivities, like I'll be doing, to find the right 50% ADS sensitivity for you, or you can use it in a completely different way to measure the input required, that is how far you have to move your mouse, typically in centimeters or whatever you prefer for your unit of measurement, for the required output, which in this case again is the 360-degree turn on your screen. And you can take that from a different game where you already like how your sensitivity feels, and then use a trial and error process to match that input to output ratio up with settings in PlanetSide 2 that will work for you. So now there's one major warning to heed before you start changing your sensitivities all willy-nilly. Obviously you want to know what you are at. You want to make backups of things. I have so many backups of my user options that INI config file for PlanetSide 2, as well as other games. I know what the numbers are off the top of my head, what my sensitivities are, how far I have to travel in centimeters, things like that. But at least make a backup of your settings, or at the very, very least know what they are. Anything that you're changing. And what I do on top of that is, once I have my backup and once I have my regular settings how I like it, I change it to read only so that nothing with the game or the patch or whatever could alter them without my permission first, and I don't accidentally have all my settings reset or anything like that. Now note that you obviously can have it on read only when you're changing them yourself, but once you find something you like, make that read only and then, you know, just make sure to uncheck it whenever you're doing something that you have to change, otherwise the settings wouldn't save. Now, that one major warning that you do need to heed before changing this sensitivity is the fact that changing it even a tiny bit will throw off your game for the short term if you become very familiar with certain settings for a prolonged amount of time. I firmly believe that it's still better to have consistent muscle memory building sensitivities across the board and throughout different games. And I'll personally be matching up my PlanetSide 2 sensitivities with my Battlefield 3, my Bad Company 2, and other previous game sensitivities that I've matched up in the past. But there is a slight relearning curve where you may be over or under aiming for a short while doing, you know, the readjustment process in PlanetSide 2. I personally think the pros outweigh the cons and that it'll be better for me in the end, but that's something that you might want to consider before fiddling with the settings. Ultimately, you can really make anything work that you become very familiar with, as it's a matter of both convenience and repetition to build the skills necessary to have the fast reaction time and good twitch aiming abilities. Now, something else worth mentioning, especially for the outliers here that play on very high or low sensitivity, the latter being my case, is that you often will benefit from adjusting your DPI, occasionally out of necessity, but even just for more precise tuning of your sensitivities. In my case, I had to drop my DPI down from the 1200 that I use in Battlefield 3 to 800 for PlanetSide 2 just to be able to get the in-game slider low enough to suit my needs. I may end up having to drop it even lower while retuning for game update 9. Now, to account for the resulting tedium, I use my Razer mouse software with profiling to automatically switch my DPI and other settings depending on the game that I'm playing. That's something worth considering for sure if you're trying to find the best settings that work for you. Now, as always, thanks so much for watching. I really hope this helps somebody out, and whether you're looking to get the perfect 50% or whatever number you're used to ADS sensitivity after the patch, or whether you wanted to be able to bring over your sensitivities from another shooter that you play regularly, or even if you just found my warning useful so that the change didn't catch you off guard when you zoom in and find your sensitivity feels way different after the patch, I really appreciate all your support, and thank you guys so much for stopping by. If you did find it useful, please go ahead and comment, rate, and subscribe to the channel to be notified of regular updates. I also have a Twitter account with the same username as my YouTube account, xitsmurdax, and I post on that pretty regularly as well. And then in addition to all of that, of course, I got my live stream that is active on a daily basis over at itsmurda.com or twitch.tv/itsmurda_tv. Thanks again, guys, and we'll see you soon.